cycle from the phylum protozoa, which is very important, that is the life cycle of Plasmodium vivax. As we all know that the Plasmodium is responsible, you are able to understand how the malaria is caused by the Plasmodium vivax, how it is completed its life cycle in human being and the body of female Anopheles mosquito, what is the pattern and incubation period, what are the pathogenicity caused due to this Plasmodium vivax, and very important one, that how we can control this malaria. So let's start. Now we can start with this Plasmodium vivax, and here we can learn about the life cycle, pathogenicity and control measures of the malaria. So first, whenever we can study and life cycle of any animal, we can first study about its systematic position. So in this Plasmodium vivax, as you know that it is belonging to the phylum Protozoa, subphylum Sporozoa, class Telosporia, order Eucocidia, genus Plasmodium and species Vivax. The Plasmodium vivax, it is lives as an intracellular parasite in the RBCs of man in the form of its mature condition, which is known as the protozoid. So as we know that intracellular means it is a parasite which is living within the cell. The meaning of intracellular is which live within the cell. So where the Plasmodium is found, the Plasmodium is widely distributed in the tropical and temperate countries of the world. So whenever we can start with the life cycle of Plasmodium, remember that it is a diagenetic. So what is the meaning of diagenetic? Means it is involving two hosts. To complete its life cycle, it requires two hosts, that type of life cycle is known as the diagenetic. So this life cycle, which is completed by both the way, that is the asexual way and the sexual phases. The asexual phase of the life cycle of Plasmodium vivax, it is completed in the human being by the process which is known as the zygote. And the sexual phase of the life cycle of Plasmodium, it is completed in the female Anopheles mosquito by the process which is known as gametogony, syngamy and sporogony. So the two important hosts to complete the life cycle of Plasmodium vivax, it is one is the human being and another one which is known as the female Anopheles mosquito. So now the question is arise, what is mean by malaria? As the Plasmodium is responsible to cause the malaria. So what is malaria? Malaria, it is a disease which is caused by the protozoan parasites of the genus Plasmodium. So there are four species are commonly known to infect the human being. These are the Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium ovale and Plasmodium malariae. These are four different species can cause the four different types of malaria which are having some different features. Okay, now we can here study the life cycle of among these four, we can here study the life cycle of Plasmodium vivax. So now the question is arise that how that malaria is transmitted. So malaria parasites, that is the Plasmodium vivax, is transmitted from one person to another by the bite of a female Anopheles mosquito. Not all of these mosquitoes are responsible to cause malaria. Only the Anopheles species of the mosquito and that female one is responsible to transmit the malaria or to transmit that malarial parasite from one person to another person. Now the female mosquito is why responsible to transfer the parasite from one person to another, because the female requires protein to nourish the eggs, and that protein she require from or obtain from the hemoglobin of the human being, and that's why the male is not responsible to transmit a malaria, but the female Anopheles mosquito is responsible to transmit the malaria. Now we can start with the process. Now first one, it is the inoculation, means how that parasite get enter inside the body of a human being, which is the process known as inoculation. So when an infected female Anopheles mosquito bites to a man to suck his blood, then along with the saliva, it injects a sporozoid stage of Plasmodium into the human blood. So the first stage which is enter into the body of the human being, it is nothing but a sporozoid, and which is known as the infective stage. If you see its measurement, so it is a microscopic, no doubt it is 11 to 12 micron in the length and having 0.5 to 1 width. It is a sickle like in shape with an oval nucleus, and during his inoculation or during when the female Anopheles mosquito inject the saliva, at that time thousands of sporozoid enter into the body of the human being. So when we see, as it is a microscopic, when we observe under the microscope, then we can see what is the structure of sporozoid. It is a sickle shaped body which is covered externally by an elastic fur pellicle, which is having longitudinally arranged contractile microtubules, and its anterior end bears an apical cap which is being made up of three or more concentric rings. So this structure of sporozoid we are able to see under only microscope. Now once it enter into the body of human being, the process it is start, which is we already mentioned that in the human being, the schizogony. This is the asexual phase of life cycle of Plasmodium vivax. So in the liver cells, once they enter into the body of human being, these sporozoid enter into the liver cell. There they start to grow, they become large, becoming round, which is known as the schizon. And now these schizons start to undergo the multiple fissions to form about 1000 to several thousand small spindle shaped cells, which is now known as the merozoids. Now they are not known as a sporozoid, they are known as merozoids. And the multiple fission itself known as the schizogony. The meaning of schizogony, that is the multiple fission. So in this way, the infection is developed into the human being. So now next one, if we see here, that is this malaria parasite. Now we can see here, so this is the phase of infection. Here we can see that the female Anopheles mosquito bites and release sporozoid into the bloodstream. And this circulates for about 30 minutes and then invade the liver. So in this way, when the female Anopheles mosquito bite and when it inject the saliva, in that saliva, a thousands of sporozoid get enter into the body of human being. And once they enter, this sporozoid enter, they attack the liver cells, which is known as the pre-erythrocytic phase, or it is also known as tissue or hepatic phase. So what happened in this? So here the sporozoid mature into the schizon, which rupture to release the merozoids. So when these sporozoid attack the fresh liver cells, they can change their shape, they grow in size, they become rounded, and now this rounded structure is known as the schizon. And these schizon undergo the multiple fission to form a number of merozoids. So these merozoids, when the as the pressure is created in this liver cell, it becomes weak, it bursts, and thousands of merozoids get free into the blood. So in this way, now these merozoids again attack to a new liver cells. So after that, the next phase is started, which is known as the erythrocytic schizogony. So after completion of many cycles in the liver, the merozoids invade red blood cells. Here they grow and mature into the trophozoite, which appear as ring forms. The trophozoites develop into the schizon, and the infected red blood cells then rupture to release the numerous merozoids from the schizon to infect other red blood cells. Merozoid release result in this fever, chills, and other symptoms of malarial infection. So here we can see that after completing many generations in the liver cells, these merozoids enter into the blood cells where they start the erythrocytic schizogony, where they attack on the fresh RBCs, where they grow, become the trophozoite, and again they form the ring-like stage. Then they again become enlarged in size. Then the pressure is created on that RBC, and that RBCs get rupture to release the numerous next merozoites. So in this way this cycle is completed. And then after completing this asexual phase in the body of human being, once there is a formation of gametocytes, then the sexual phase of the life cycle is started, which is not occur in the body of the human being, but it occur into the body of female Anopheles mosquito. So the last stage which is found in the body of human being, it is the formation of gametocytes. After that, the further life cycle is completed into the body of the malaria, that is the female Anopheles mosquito. So here we can see the Cezanne vein rupture, the merozoites are liberated into the venous passage of the liver, and this is known as the pre-erythrocytic cyzogony. And these merozoite produced are, they are known as the cryptozoites. These are minute, these are very minute, and these are immune to the medicines and resistance of the host. So medicines are not having any effect on these cryptozoites. The second phase of asexual multiplication, which is also known as the exoerythrocytic cyzogony, which occur in the liver cells, in which the cryptozoites enter into the new liver cells and grow into the cezanne. So this cezanne divides to form the merozoites, and these merozoites of second generation are called as the metacryptozoites. So merozoites of the second generation are of two types. One is more numerous and which is known as the macro metacryptozoites, and smaller one is known as the micro cryptozoites. So these micro and macro, these two types of merozoites are produced in the second generation. So micro metacryptozoites, these are start to invade the RBCs, and there they start the erythrocytic cyzogony. Why? The macro metacryptozoites, they are entered into the liver cell and continue the exoerythrocytic cyzogony. So simultaneously the liver and RBCs get infected by these merozoites. So now the one of the most important terms which we have to be studied here, or we have to be learned here, is that the pre-pattern and incubation period. The pre-pattern, what is pre-pattern? Pre-pattern, it is the duration between the initial sporozoite infection and the first appearance of parasite in the blood. So in the Plasmodium vivax, it is about 8 days in an average. Means when the sporozoid get enter inside the body of the human being, and the first symptom, first that parasite seen in the blood, that duration is 8 days. So 8 days are required for that sporozoid to get enter into the blood. The incubation period is different one. So what is incubation? The incubation period, it is the time taken from the infection of man by sporozoid till the appearance of first malarial symptom in that human being. So in Plasmodium vivax, it is about 14 days in an average, ranging from 10 to 17 days. So incubation period means where the first that sporozoid enter into the body and the first appearance of the malarial symptom. So we know that the main features of malaria, or the diagnostic features of malaria, is that there is a very high grade fever, and alternate after every 48 hours that cycle is repeated. There is a high grade fever and severe coldness is from severe coldness the patient is suffering. So these symptoms, so the appearance of this symptom and the time between the entrance of this sporozoid. So this is the time when the sporozoid enter inside the blood and first appearance of malarial symptoms. So this is near about 14 days, which range from 10 to 17 days. So these two periods are very important. Pre-pattern period of Plasmodium vivax is about 8 days, and the incubation period of that Plasmodium vivax, it is 14 days in an average. So this is the diagrammatic chart where we can see how this life cycle is completed. All these part we can see here, which is completed in the human being. The asexual phase of life cycle is completed in the body of human being by the process known as the cyzogony. And this is the sexual phase of life cycle, which is completed into the body of the human being. So if you see here, this symbol indicate the infective state. So sporozoid, it is the infective state. And this symbol which known as the diagnostic state. So at that stage, we can diagnose that either that patient is suffering from malaria or not. So here, this is the life cycle. Now, what are the symptoms and pathogenicity? As we know that it is a parasite, so no doubt the many harms are produced by these parasites. So malaria, which is caused by the Plasmodium vivax, it is known as the benign pteridine malaria. So the symptoms which is shown by this malaria is, that is the vomiting, the patient is suffering from the vomiting, diarrhea, more commonly seen in the young children, it may be sometime misdiagnosed as a viral gastroenteritis. Then the anemia is also seen in this, because the large amount of RBCs start to destroy by this Plasmodium vivax pallor, which is resulting mainly from the lysis of the red blood cells, and jaundice, which is mainly due to the hemolysis. So vomiting, diarrhea, anemia, pallor, jaundice, and as it is a multi-system disease, some other common clinical features which are seen in it is as the analgesia, headache is also seen, then muscle acne is HS are also seen, tender, hepatomegaly is also seen here there. So all these are the symptoms which are shown by the malaria caused by the Plasmodium vivax. Now the main question is arise that how we can control this malaria. As such, many people are died due to this malaria every year all over the world. So how we can control this malaria? So as we know that the malarial parasite Plasmodium vivax require two hosts, that is the human being and a mosquito, and particularly female Anopheles mosquito. So in this control measure, now we can see how we can control the mosquitoes, because if we control the mosquitoes, ultimately the life cycle of the Plasmodium vivax will be break. Okay, it is not completed, because it require the body of, because the sexual phase is completed only into the body of the female Anopheles mosquito. So for the controlling the malaria, we are trying to prevent the mosquito. So how we can control the mosquitoes? So first, by killing the mosquitoes. So in human dwelling, by spraying them with DDT, which remain toxic to the mosquitoes for several months. So first one, which we can call destruction of the secondary host, because in this life cycle of Plasmodium, the secondary host is a mosquito. By the filling up ditches, as we know that the mosquito breed in a water, it can lay its eggs in a water. So ditches in the rainy season, whenever there is an pond, there is a formation of ponds, or there is a formation of ditches, you have to fill up that ditches so that no area is found to that mosquito to lay its eggs. And number third, which we can be said that by spraying surface of ponds with the kerosene oil, so, or with insecticides which kill the larvae. As a we can see the life cycle of this mosquito, the four stages are very important. Eggs, after the eggs, larva is coming out, this larva is converted into the pupa, and pupa is finally converted into that adult mosquito. So the larvae and pupa, these two stages of the mosquito which are found in the water, eggs, larvae and pupa. So if we cover the ponds, as the pond is a large one, so it is not possible to fill up that pond. So at such time, if we spread the if we introduce certain fish, okay, which is the natural enemies of mosquito, because they feed on the larvae and pupae, and also if we spread the kerosene oil in that, so due to kerosene oil, it is not possible to mix the atmospheric oxygen into the water of that pond. So due to the lack of the oxygen or deficiency of the oxygen, ultimately that larvae or pupa which is found in the pond, it will be dead. So it involves the defense against mosquito bite. And our next one, which we can be called it as, we have to protect ourselves against the mosquito bites. For that, we can use the nets, insect repellents, and other many things which are available in the markets. So this is, we can be called it as a prevention of the infection. And last one, after doing all these, if we are having, or we are having that particular malaria, or someone is suffering from the malaria, then last stage to control is, that is the treatment of the infected person. So for that, the quinine, chloroquine, atribine, these are the some medicines which is useful to control the to control or to treat the patients of malaria. So in this way, here we can see about the plasmodium. We can see all about the how the life cycle of Plasmodium vivax is completed, how the sexual phase is completed into the body of the human being, how the sexual phase is completed into the body of the female Anopheles mosquito, how are the pathogenicity caused due to this Plasmodium vivax, and how we can control this malaria. So I hope you can understand this lecture very well. Thank you.